beautiful, full of energy, and full of love.
As I'm older, I realize why I've been drawn to the river, because that's always been something that I like to do. Go down to the river and sit, contemplate. I think it's a really great thing that we're deciding to use the river for what it was intended, and that was something to celebrate.
I really enjoy going for long walks and runs with my children. I miss here in the city the safety of being able to do that at any time. If there was basketball tournaments or gardens or any kind of activities that they could say, hey, let's go play bocce ball or let's go play tennis.
I wanted to really cater to the needs of residents, but I also want them to see the natural beauty of it. I want them to be able to touch the water.
Detroit is an amazing city with rich neighborhoods, great people, real sense of pride and place. And through meeting with different people with the community, we found Detroit to be at once tough and resilient, creative and industrious, pragmatic and optimistic. How can a new waterfront park embody this spirit of Detroit? Many people told us that they wanted a park where they can come and do things, where they can play, eat, exercise, fish, boat, garden, perform. A park of verbs, not nouns. A park of invitations, offerings, places for activity and events, things to do. So recognizing this need for activation and inspired by Detroit street life, we first focused on the street edge, creating a threshold along Jefferson Street with people doing things along the frontage of the park. Community gardens, urban farms, tailgating strips, barbecue cookouts, pickup games, hoops, play features, art spaces, a small cafe and kiosks, and other such amenities. And to extend the season, a large shed-like open trellis sits overhead, providing an assembly line-like armature for vibrant lighting, utilities like water and electricity, and potential cover and weather protection in certain areas. And we call this the street porch, a big scene. In the middle of the site, we thought to contrast street urbanism with a soft landscape. Inspired by the Native American Indian mounds and earthworks that dot Michigan, we sculpt a series of gentle mounds to create a scenographic landscape where views and vistas are revealed with movement, and where higher levels offer prospect and outlook, and lower levels offer refuge and enclosure with some protection from winds. Stormwater is collected in a series of wetland gardens in these lower areas too, and trees are used dramatically to create open copses and groves atop the mounds. Along the waterfront, we sought to break up the repetitive singularity of the esplanade and to create instead a series of docks, piers, terraces, landings, and other spaces that reflect varied opportunities for how people can use the waterfront. There are spaces for fishing, picnicking, theater, boating, kayaking, festivals, as well as for everyday strolls, jogs, and just relaxing. Riparian terraces allow for wetland habitat and gardens to engage the water's edge. And tying the three bands together are a series of curvilinear pathways, emphatically drawing the visitor from the street to the waterfront docks, and a running track supports a measured mile run. Taken together, this vision represents a park for everybody, a large green setting with myriad places and opportunities for people to come, gather, have fun, and enjoy.
This design beautifully captures the many needs and aspirations of the Detroit community. People here want open space, trees, nature, gardens, but they also want to get together and do things. Grow vegetables together, cook and eat together, play ball, run together, and just enjoy their own friends and family.